Okay, thank you. Thank you, Ramanand. A very good morning to all of you. I hope everybody is fine. Before we start today's lecture, I would like to inform you that we'll be having a quiz next week. How we are going to take that, the details will follow. When exactly do you want it? I can give you the choice to choose the date. Ramanan, do you have any specific date in mind, the class? After two or three? I'm saying next week, Ramanan. Tell me a date next week. It's not completely, like we'll have, let's say, 14 is far away, next week. Ramanand, since we have, like, I'll break up the syllabus. I mean, only up to network layer we can have the quiz. So you tell me next week when? You want to take to the other extreme, is it? Okay, 11th, let it be 11th. Because then we need some more time to have the second one as well. That would cover the rest of the syllabus. Okay, that's fine. So 11th is fixed. 10th is fine. Okay, I'm just writing here. 10 June. Okay, once we finish the syllabus, we can have the right time also. So inform everybody, for those who haven't joined here, that we'll have our first quiz on 10th of June. The details of how it will be will follow, right? But I would want that, I mean, everybody be there, everybody would join. I mean, there won't be repeat quizzes, so unless you know there is like such a problem that they really couldn't join in. But anyhow, as of now, and tell them there will be no repeat quizzes, so ensure they are joining here. So continue with our flow control protocols. Okay, flow control protocols are basically divided into two categories. One is for non-noisy channels, another is for the noisy channels. Non-noisy channels typically use stop and wait, right? And the noisy channels that we have is having sliding window protocols, and those sliding window protocols have stop and wait, selective repeat, and go back and ARQ, where ARQ stands for automatic repeat request. As the name itself says, it's automatic repeat request. Stop and wait, just a revision of yesterday's work. This was a stop and wait, a simple protocol. You send a packet, you receive the acknowledgement, then you send the next packet, you receive the acknowledgement, and that's how it worked. The second one that we took after stop and wait was the go back and sliding window protocol. We had the slide for that as well. It was not a pipeline protocol, so we tried to increase the utilization. We saw there were some disadvantages with respect to our first protocol, that was the stop and wait protocol. Some of the disadvantages were that it had a simplex transmission. Data flow was only on one direction. It was ideal only for large frames to send large packets, but then we partitioned the frames. I gave you yesterday the reasons why we partition the frame. We do not send it all together. Why? Error checking is fast when you have this small size. We reduce the amount of data that is required for retransmission. as well as you have to take care about the buffer sizes as well as the MTUs and MSV. Then after this, we saw the pipelining, wherein we had an increase of the efficiency. That was sliding window flow control protocol, commonly referred to as GBN or go back N. Now, what we had is, rather than sending one packet, we had a window size that could accommodate number of packets. So within this window, we had the acknowledgement numbers of those packets, and some the green ones which were already received successfully, and then we have the yellow ones which were sent but acknowledgement not received. Once acknowledgements were received, then only it would move further towards right and so on. Once it moved a step or two steps or three steps towards the right, accordingly, once we got the acknowledgements, let's say we got three acknowledgements, the window would move towards right, having three more segments within it, three more sequence numbers within it. This we discussed yesterday in detail. This was the sender's window. The sender window would have on the left extreme the blue ones, those are sent and acknowledgement, and in the middle we had something like this. Some sent, not acknowledgement. Some are to be sent but data is not received, and after this it was not usable. It would be usable once you get the data and once the window would move towards the right. This was the sender side window, and we had the receiver window as well. And what was the receiver window? Receiver window size was always one. It would simply give the acknowledgement of what it has received. It would simply say, yes, I have received this one, and it would move to the next one and so on. And also we saw a few things that was in the first one, that was the first one that we took, that was stop and wait. Okay, we saw the acknowledgement that we received was the number that said send me the next one. For example, if packet 0 had arrived, so what was the acknowledgement? The receiver would send the acknowledgement as 1, meaning I am expecting packet number 1 to be sent. This we took in yesterday's class. And also, when we took the second one, that is GBN, the same thing, in which we could have cumulative acknowledgements as well. In this case, okay, if we send the acknowledgement, all right. So in this case, what would happen is that once you send the acknowledgement, once you receive the packet, so the size of window was decided to be 1. And what was the acknowledgement number sent as? The acknowledgement number was cumulative. Okay. And what we mean by cumulative? If we got an acknowledgement, for example, as 6, if our acknowledgement number was 6, what did it mean? It meant that all the packets till number 5 have been arrived safe and sound. And now I am expecting the packet number 6. So in GBN, acknowledgement number 6 meant up to 5 received, now send me number 6. This is clear. Did we have any questions? All right, Marina, are you able to hear me? Okay, Rafiq, I think yeah, it's a problem from your end. Since Ramanand is recording it, so it should not be an issue. It will be uploaded, okay? Then you can check it. Try to disconnect and reconnect. See, maybe that will help, or change your location, move a bit here and there. All right. Okay, so now we'll move to the third one and the last one of flow control protocols that we know as selective repeat. Do we have any questions till now? This also we took yesterday. This is the receiver sender window and the receiver window. Rafiq, audible now? Please check. Okay. Rafiq, please check your audio now. Okay, let me continue with select to repeat. Now the go back and GBN protocol simplifies the process at the receiver. Why? Because receiver window was one. Receiver keeps track of only one variable. There is no need of receiver buffer because, I mean, it does not take care of out of order packets. Then what does it do? It simply discards the out of order packet. How? We saw it in the last class. Let me go back here. See, let's have a look here. Let's try to understand. I'm now explaining the problem with GBN. GBN gave us cumulative acknowledgement. Good. GBN could send a number of packets together. So pipelining was there. That is fine. But what happened here? Packet 0 was sent. Let me just do annotation. Okay. Now let's see here. Packet 0 was sent here. Packet 0 was received here. No issues with it. Okay. Packet 0 was sent. Packet 0 received. Feedback sent. No problem. Packet 1 sent. Received. Acknowledgement sent. Packet 2 was sent. Fine, and it was lost. So obviously it received, there is missing acknowledgement as well. But since in the window, the size of the window was 4, so 4 packets were sent. Third one was received, fourth one was received successfully. Now the receiver has only one window size. And what does it do? It gets 0, 0 acknowledge, move to the next. It gets 1, 1 acknowledge, move to the next. It now expects, once the acknowledgement of 1 is sent, so it expects now 2 to receive. But 2 is not received, 3 is received. What does it do? It discards. It discards that. Then what does it do instead? It sends the acknowledgement 1 again, means I am now expecting packet number 2. So if on this end our window had moved down because 2 were acknowledged, so we could take 2 more. Now window size is this, which says 2, 3. The latecomers, I need to accept the request. That takes me some time, so better be on time. So since it moved to packet 2, 3, 4 and 5, however, packet 2's acknowledgement was not received, 4 was sent, 5 was sent, the receiver is expecting packet number 2, it receives now 4, it discards again, it receives 5, it discards again. And in reply to 3rd, 4th, 5th, it has sent again acknowledgement 1, acknowledgement 1, means send me first packet number two, send me first packet number two, send me first packet number two. And once the source gets this first acknowledgement here, okay, it had a duplicate acknowledgement. Packet 2's timeout went. It did not get the acknowledgement of packet 2, means did not get ACK3, means 2 has been received, send 3. What does it do then? It resends the packet 2. Now once it resends the packet number 2 here, that is this one after the timeout, it receives packet 2, delivered, send the acknowledgement. Then 3, 4, 5, because we had the window of this and window moves down and this. So what was the problem here? The problem was that this was discarded, this was discarded, this was discarded. And what was the reason here for discarding this? The reason was that we have only receiver window as one. It takes track. It has only one variable. There is no buffer. Out of order packets, because 1, 2 is fine, 2 is missing, 3 is deleted, 4 is deleted, 5 is discarded. Out of order packets are discarded in this flow control protocol, that is GBN. So what do we do here? We move on to selective repeat instead. Why? Because the GBN is actually inefficient protocol. It causes loss of lot of packets. All the packets which are not in ordered, which come after the packet that has been lost, are to be discarded by that protocol. So to improve the efficiency, okay, what was the inefficiency? Each time a single packet is lost or corrupted, the sender has to resend all the outstanding packets that we saw here. All the outstanding packets were resent, which in this case 2, 3, 4, whereas 3, 4, 5 was already sent, but they were thrown out. So the sender resends all outstanding packets, even though some of these packets may have been received safe, sound, but out of order. It was received here, it was received here, it was received here. They were received safe, sound, their error correction checking all was okay, but still they got discarded. Okay, this is where we improve in selective repeat. The name itself says selective repeat. So what do we do in selective repeat? The selective repeat protocol resends only selective packets, those are actually lost, which in other terms means if 2 was lost here and 3 was received safely, ask for 2 only to be resent. Take 3, 4, 5 because they have been correctly received. Okay, but once your window cannot move beyond it, okay, wait for 2 to come. That we will see in this slide. So receiver individually acknowledges all correctly received packets. Means, what is the change that we need to make in the protocol? The receiver should be able to buffer the packets. So buffer the packets at the receiver. How? Means, if let's see here. How to buffer it? See, the same case, the window 4, but this time we use selective repeat. The selective repeat protocol here would allow many packets because of pipelining, depending upon the size of the window. And as the size of the receive window is also there, we would have, you know, receive window. If out of order packets are received, which in this case here, let's say 1, 0 is received correctly, 1 is received correctly, 2nd is lost, 3rd is received correctly. What happens to 3rd here? Buffer it. Buffer the 3rd one. And send acknowledgement of 3rd. What is the acknowledgement for the previous one? It received packet 0, send acknowledgement as 0. See the difference there, here. It received packet one, sent the acknowledgement of packet one. Two was lost, so it couldn't send anything. Three was received, but buffer it. And also sent the acknowledgement of third one. Which means, in selective repeat, the receiver window is same size as the send window. Let us go back a bit. Here, in selective repeat, sender and receiver windows are same. The above one you see, the first one is the, this one is the sender window and this is the receiver window. And because of this size of the receiver window, we can have out of packet orders received and buffered. And they will be kept there until we get the one which we are missing, so that we form back the sequence in order and then we pass on to the application layer. Right? We have to keep in mind that reliable protocol, typically TCP, does not deliver out of order packets to the application layer. Yes, we made it clear at the beginning also. And I repeat here also that reliable protocol, the receiver will never deliver the packets out of order to the application layer. So I'm not saying that we will deliver out of order packets to the application. We are saying we will receive out of order packets. No problem, as long as our window can take, as long as our window can buffer. But it's just a buffer until the packet that has been lost is received. Once that packet is received, we put them back in order and then the ordered message 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in order is delivered to the receiver's application layer. I hope that is clear. So let's try to understand here the window here. The first part that we see, let's leave these two unusable. This is unusable here. Forget about it. This is unusable. Forget about it at the moment. Now, in this case, the blue one is usable and can be sent. So, I'll mark it here. This one is usable, but this is usable, but these are not sent yet. What is left now? In this, these many have been sent, which I will mark, let's say with pink. These many have been sent, the one which are in the pink. Okay. And within these, some packets have been received and acknowledgement is also received. Among these, the green one depict those, like these one, like this one and this one, that this has been sent and acknowledgement has been received. Fine. And also, there are some which have been depicted in yellow that they are sent but their acknowledgement has not been received. Now, move on to the receiver window. The green one which are depicted here, the dark green one, this is packets which are already received. Okay, means that I have received it and acknowledgement has been sent. No issue. So the window is here. See the window here from here to here. In this case, the pink one are the out of order packets that are received, they are buffered. Fine. And this is received, but it has not received one of the packets that is in between, that is the gray one. It is expected but not received. So packets here can be received and stored for later delivery. It has some more space here as well. This is acceptable within the receiver's window. So packets can be received and stored for later delivery. And some within here have already been received and some are waiting. Let's understand it with acknowledgements now. That will make it a bit clear. Let's understand it with this one. Now to understand acknowledgements, go back and end, that was the previous one. We mentioned that we have a cumulative acknowledgement. What was cumulative acknowledgement in GBN? That if I say acknowledgement number is 6, all the packets till 5 have been received. And what is the acknowledgement in GBN? The sequence number of next packet expected. So when we send the sequence number of next packet to be expected, it confirms that all previous packets have been received safe and sound. That was GBN. Move on to the SR, that is selective repeat. See here, packet 0 is sent. Packet 0 is received, send ACK0. We are not sending ACK1 here. What does it mean here? It means that in selective repeat, the acknowledgement number defines the sequence number of a single packet that is received safe and sound. There is no feedback for any other previously received packets. Neither does it mention to be like which is the next number it is expecting. Is this part clear? It's an important distinction between all the three protocols that we have understood. I repeat, packet 0 is sent, acknowledgement 0 is sent back. If this was GBN, packet, let's say packet 1 was sent, it would have sent acknowledgement 2. Why? It would say that I have received everything till packet 1 and now I am expecting packet 2. But in selective repeat, this doesn't happen. In selective repeat, an acknowledgement number defines the sequence number of a single packet that it has received. I have received packet 1, take the acknowledgement number of packet 1. What about 0? 0's acknowledgement would be sent separately. So whether it has been sent or whether it has not been sent, okay? It doesn't care about it at this place. It would send only the acknowledgement of that packet it has received. That's why I said there is no feedback for any other. It doesn't mention the previous one or it doesn't mention which next one is expected. Let's go ahead with it. See what happens next. So receiver received these. Fine. Now one of the packets was lost. Third was sent. Third came out of order. It buffered. Send acknowledgement of third. Fine. So third is arrived. Then what would happen? Since the window moved from here to here, since the window moved from here to here, we got two more entries here. That is 4 and 5. Because window size is 4. So 4 was sent, 5 was sent. It received packet 4. It buffered. Sent acknowledgement for 4. It received packet 5, it buffered send acknowledgement till 5. It will buffer packets as many as it can based on the window size, that is 4. So receiver's window has moved here as well, because 2 is acknowledged here, 0 and 1 packet. So once window moved here also 2 steps, here acknowledgement was sent, the window also moved 2 steps. That means window here can buffer 4 packets. But in this case, it's still waiting for packet number 2. Timeout happened for packet 2, right? It resent packet 2. What is the difference here between the previous one? It did not send packet number 3, 4, 5 again. It only resent packet number 2 because 3, 4, 5 have been received safely. It is selective repeat. Selective in the sense that only one packet was not received, it was lost, send that packet only. Now, it delivers packet 2. Good. It had buffered packet 3, 4, 5. It sends the acknowledgement 2. For the rest 3, it has already sent the acknowledgement 4. It has already sent the acknowledgement 5. It has already sent the acknowledgement. In this case, it will order this 2, 3, 4 and 5 together. Is this clear? Fine. And then it can move. What happens when acknowledgement 2 arrives? See. As long as this had happened, there was no issue with it. Latecomers, I need to. Okay, so I think I'll let you do this problem. There is an issue with the selective repeat here. All right, I'll give this task for you to understand this task. Okay. Since I'm giving some assignments, so I might mention this there as well. There's an issue with the selective repeat, which is mentioned here. Alright, so this covers our flow control as well. Any questions till now? We've taken care of three-way handshake also. Is there anything left that we did not take? Okay. Think about a bit of condition control. Now, what do we have here with respect to the condition control? Now, if we have too many sources sending too much of data too fast, in which a router in between or the network nodes cannot handle, we will have a condition which is known as congestion. An example in this picture is given here. A lot of roads are coming into a rendezvous, and in that rendezvous, you know, you would have a congestion because many roads are ending there. And how is it different than flow control? Till now we were also discussing that, you know, data has been sent, but it's sent too fast that receiver cannot take care of it. In flow control, one sender sends too fast to a receiver. Whereas in congestion control, we have too many senders sending too fast. So the effect of congestion control would be network wide. It will overall have the effect on the network. Okay. Compared to that, one sender, one receiver, mostly it would have localized effect of flow control. And because of congestion being an overall network wide effect, see here, the example of the picture is shown here, you know, dog getting too much of water from the hose here, and the congestion here, it shows the roads which are blocked and there's a huge traffic jam which you can see. That's why I said a network wide process and a localized process. Congestion control are too many receivers, too many senders, whereas flow control is one receiver, one sender. And what protocols we use to stop in one sender, one receiver? Flow control, go back and selective repeat and so on. TCP is the reliable delivery service, we took care of it. Now, if we have a condition in which we have an overall congestion in the network, this would create an overall problem of long delays. Why? There will be a lot of queuing at the buffers within the network nodes in between, like routers and so on. And because it's not that you can tell the source to slow down, because it's not a flow control, it's not one sender, one receiver, the buffers would easily overflow in this case. And when we realize that once the buffer overflows, the packets are lost. And that's how the congestion control is different than the flow control. Here is an example given, okay, which depicts the congestion control or the scenario one. We have a red link between host A and the server. We have a blue link between the another host B and another server. In this case, if there was a single link between the single data transfer, that is the red one, okay, you could have used your flow controls in which you would have informed the host A to reduce it. However, in this case, we have two flows, okay? And because of this, the capacity of the buffer in the router is finite in between. And we know that in case of internet here, packet switching networks, we have statistical multiplexing in which some packets of A would be taken and some packets of B would be taken, because of finite buffer. And the sender, accordingly would have to retransmit the packets which are lost. Because of the limited buffer, a lot of packets would be lost. This creates a problem which is known as congestion. Now here they have been given an example of how it will affect the throughput, how many retransmissions and so on would be required in these cases. This shows the example of what are the effects of congestion, the losses and so on. But I believe we have taken care of the most of the things that we had required for the transport layer. Okay, then I have some more stuff to do, which I am supposed to give you some assignments. We'll take care of in that as well. I'll give you some condition control protocols as well. That should be the end of the transport layer. The next layer that we are going to take about is the session layer. That is layer number 5. Time here. I think we'll take that in next week's class. I'll give you some time to revise for the rest. I think we'll end here, Ramanand. So we are left with the now session presentation, right? And application layer. So I believe next 4 or 5 classes we should be done. The week after we'll be done. Okay, any questions till now? Yes, because of the as per the notice, there would be some time given before the final exam for the lab. So I had started the lab, but since that notice came up, so I thought, let's see, we'll have 1 month for completion of labs. But maybe it won't be possible now, you know, like we had thought that there will be exam and so on. So we might have to online go ahead with the labs after this. I'm waiting for what next thing would come. Okay, director has come to the office today. So there may be some notices coming up soon. In the meantime, we'll finish our syllabus. As always, we will have our quizzes and assignments done. So our assessment part would also be done. That way. Then remaining would be the lab, and we'll see how final is taken. Right. Okay, I'll see you in the next week. I'm not sure yet. Like I said, director has arrived in the college. So there might be some meetings and we'll get to know. All right.